What's up guys, JTales here with another video, and today I'm going to be giving you 5 tips to win more with Palutena. Let's get right into it, shall we? The first thing I want to talk about Palutena and basically cover is I think that you guys need to use her fair a lot more. Her fair is safe, it's a safe poke, it's almost lagless, like she can just shield instantly after. And it's a combo starter, it just does everything. This move is really good, and I know everyone's favorite is Nair for obvious reasons, but the thing is, using Nair gives you bad habits. I see so many Palutenas online, I'm literally nowhere near them, and this is what they're doing. And it's like, you're not even thinking about what movement you're doing and why, right? And then I just punish their landing, or I counter, and they get bodied. And they probably get frustrated. So, forward airs is better in every capacity, because if you land this, you get a grab. And then you can fair as well. You can do so much off of forward air. If you land it, you can dash attack as well. True combo. You can falling fair, grab, down throw, fair. Like you get so much off of forward air, and it's just really good for momentum. You get fair into dash attack, guaranteed, and then you can try to find the landing there with another dash attack or a neutral air. When you get your grab at mid to high percent, go for the down throw into raw back air. True combo, and it does KO opponents pretty early too. Right? So you saw it was a true combo, and then DK's in a bad position. We could probably back air him here, he's dead. But either way, like, down throw bear is just so good. So basically how to do this is, I'm doing the down throw, and as it's happening, I'm holding left slightly. I don't have the stick completely pressed to the left. What I'm doing is I'm lightly tapping, like, I'm barely moving it to the left, right? So I'm doing down throw, and while the throw's happening, I'm tilting to the left, right? So you see how Palutena is already like turning around. So now what I do is, as soon as I know that she's gonna turn around, I jump. Right? So you see how I have my back to Donkey Kong already? So then when she jumps, I go for the back air. I just, instead of jumping and pressing nothing, I jump and I hit back air. So that's basically how you do it. And you can practice it step by step by doing the down throw and practicing your buffered turnaround. And then once you get the turnaround, practice doing a turnaround jump. After, oh, I didn't wait for it. I messed up. Down throw, turnaround, see? Turnaround jump. And then you do down throw, turnaround jump bear, right? And then you get the KO. So definitely use this, especially if you grab your opponent by the ledge. This will KO lighter characters pretty early, and it's just a nice surprise. People can DI this, but a lot of people still fall for it, even at high level. I don't know why, but they just do. Because the only other kill throw that Palutena has is back throw, and if she grabs you over here, you don't have to hold towards the stage, because forward throw will never KO. Forward throw has set knockback. So if you're fighting Palutena and you're dying to this, hold away from her. Hold to the left. Like in this case, you would hold to the left to make that not work. Because even if she forward throws you, it's never going to kill you, even if you're holding the wrong direction. It's set knockback. So if you're not holding anything or you're holding towards, you're dead. Because then that makes this the down throw bear 100% true. So just something to be mindful of, right? One of the best moves in the game, in my opinion, is this up air. I think this up air is extremely oppressive. It's a huge hitbox. It doesn't let anyone come down. You can influence it so well. You can double jump up air and do it very quickly. It's just really good. So basically, like, people shouldn't really be coming down when you're playing Palutena. You should always be trapping the landings, and I know this is something that a lot of people don't even keep in mind, but you can use up tilt and up air. Like, and even if they air dodge, guess what? You get to dash attack their landing, right? So even if I did a full hop up air and they dodged, I get to punish the air dodge. Because they're going to land horizontally, right? So you can still punish left or right when you fast fall and then touch the ground. So just something to keep in mind, up air is definitely slept on, and I think it's one of her very best moves. I just think it's a ridiculous move in the game. And you could also use explosive flame to make people dodge. And then when they dodge, you can punish them with dash attack or whatever else. You're probably wondering why I'm on Pokemon Stadium. Well, this also works on Battlefield or any other stage with a platform. Basically, the fourth tip is make sure that you get your warp cancels down, right? Warp canceling is when you teleport. See, I just did it there. So you saw how I did a double teleport there? Basically, there's a certain distance in which you can warp to the edge of the platform. And once you do this, it actually allows you to warp again if you really want to. Zelda can do this. I think Mewtwo can do it too, any character that has a teleport. So your goal is basically you want to warp to the exact ledge. And by doing this, what you're doing is you're canceling the lag of your first teleport. And then you're able to act. See, so I can perform another action, I can counter if I want. See that? So warp canceling is just a good mix-up. I wouldn't recommend that you always do this because it becomes obvious, right? The reason that it looks cool is because you're able to do two actions at once. People will know you're trying to warp cancel because it only works from certain distances. So if I see Palutena hanging around over here, I know she's going to try to warp cancel. So you can use it as a mix-up, but just keep in mind that it's not unbeatable. Your opponent can throw out a hitbox at the warp location, and you're going to get hit. So try not to make it obvious, but if you need just another option to mix things up, understand this diagonal distance so that you can get your warp cancels. And this works on any platform, I'm pretty sure, in the game. Yeah, see, I just did it right there on this transformation. So it's just something to keep in mind. And you can do this on all platform stages, Lilat, Battlefield, Smashville, Town and City, whatever you need. Just make sure you practice this in training so that you don't mess it up. The last and final tip I have for you guys is I don't think you should generally use auto reticle in neutral. This move is really, really bad. Let me show you how bad I think this move is. So DK's jumping, right? He's not, you know, he's not programmed to do anything else. Notice how, regardless of when I hit the button, aside from there, right, on the way up, but generally, DK can avoid auto reticle just by jumping. Obviously, you can avoid it by shielding too. But auto reticle is, in my opinion, one of the worst projectiles in the game. The only way it's good is off stage. If your opponent's off stage and your opponent's like Little Mac or Incineroar, then it's very good to use because they can't really do much about it, right? But in neutral, when your opponent is on the stage facing you, auto reticle is, I think it's as good as useless. Any good player is going to react to the startup of the move and either block it or jump it while approaching you. The move actually has a lot of lag once she shoots and you're stuck holding that scepter, right? So a lot of the times when I'm fighting Palutena players, I'll wait for them to do this just so that I can body them and start my combo. So be careful with this. Also be careful with explosive flame. It has a lot of, you know, it's not as fast as you think it is. It has a lot of startup. So if your opponent sees that spark, they can just keep moving forward past it, and now you're going to get punished. Or they can jump over it, or they could just block it and then just wait, right? It doesn't really have the value that you think it does in neutral. I don't think really, even at high level, you don't really see Palutena throwing projectiles because it's not a good idea. It doesn't accomplish much. However, when it is good is when your opponent's above you, and they're trying to come down, and you set up like an explosive flame there. Now they have to air dodge, right? Now they can't land, and they have to dodge or they die. So when your opponent's falling, especially far off stage, I think that's the best time to use explosive flame because then they'll dodge right into you, and then you can cover their dodge, right? With a nair, with an up tilt, with an up air. Same thing for covering the ledge. Right, so if your opponent's hanging on the ledge I think it's decent pressure to go ahead. Like, if you're not ledge trapping them, you can go ahead and throw an explosive flame there. I'm pretty sure if they're still hanging on, it will hit them. If they jump, it will hit them. If they get up attack, it can hit them. The only thing that beat it are roll and forward get up that's timed very well. So it's not a bad idea to use explosive flame to cover the when your opponent's hanging on the ledge like this. Then I think it's okay. It's not the best, but my favorite part is when they're falling and they have no choice but to dodge. Then it leads into a lot of mix-ups. And keep in mind that explosive flame has two distances. Forward and B simultaneously. That's the far one. And then holding forward and pressing B. Right? That's the close one. You see how that one's like on the orange building? And now the far one's like on the brown building, right? Those are the only two distances that this move has. So don't forget about that and make sure that you use both of them when they're needed. In any case, guys, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. I'd greatly appreciate that. And let me know in the comments who you want to see next. Please consider supporting the Patreon, guys, even if it's just $1 a month. It really does help keep this channel alive. It really helps me be able to do what I love to do. And even if it's just a dollar from, you know, even 1% of you guys, that would honestly change my life. So definitely please consider supporting. And yeah, that's pretty much it. The link is in the description for that. Thank you guys for watching as always, and I will see you all next time.